You referencing you in L.A., it was a live show we were doing, Keith and the Girls show in L.A., one of the first live shows we did many years ago. And saw Bert there, and I don't remember if you were a mess or not. I'm sure I was having a good time. I remember the bars, Happy Endings Bar.
Oh, yeah.
And at the time, and they fixed it since then. I don't know if it's because of my debacle. But, you know, it's supposed to be, quite frankly, it's me and him, the celebration, you know, we get to be with the fans and all that. Well, you know, I'm eating, I'm drinking. Next thing you know, I got to take a big shit. I go into the bathroom. There's a stall there, but the stall isn't enclosed. It's open. So there's like 3-4 urinals it's one of those long troughs where everybody pisses in like a cow. And so they have this big trough, and then in the corner they have the toilet. It's not even in the corner. It's like in the middle of the room almost. And so I'm shitting there because I have to, and I can't help it. And in walk Keith and the Girl listeners, Keith and the Girl fans, shaking my hand. Great show. Let me take a quick picture. Oh, so humiliating.
Honestly, like at that point.
I had my hand over my face. I'm like, get the fuck out. I'm yelling at my fans. Get the fuck out.
You must have really connected with your fans.
That's what they know. No other show no other person talks to me like Keith Malley does. Interacts like Keith Malley. He was on the shitter.
That's this disgusting.
It would never be okay with me. My poo would turtle up.
Mm-hmm.
And unless I had alternatives, here are the alternatives. All the people that want to come in and shake my hand, one of you is standing guard outside until I'm ready to open the door. Or you come and get me and be like, I need to use the ladies' room. You need to stand outside and say, you know, it's being cleaned or something.
I think I had somebody block the door, but he kept taking pictures.